I'm not creeped out by a lot. But when there's a small dinosaur on our ceiling, that creeps me out a little bit. Do you see that dinosaur, Father?
Yeah. What is this?
It's a dinosaur. Huh? Those are supposed to be extinct, not in our hotel room. Why is there a dinosaur up there? And how do we get it out? Because I will not be able to sleep.
Stand in the chair with the umbrella.
And then what? Then the dinosaur gets one of those big manes, goes, and then jumps out at us.
Oh, he's a big sucker.
Yeah, I know, he's huge. No, no, wait, oh, no, I need to get up on something first. I am not going to be on the ground while you are doing that. I'm going to be standing on this bed. Oh, there he goes, he's running away. Come on, go out the window. Please go out the window. Please go out the window. Please. Punch. Oh. Can't get the banana. Oh!
Whoa! Oh.
Keep the banana. Oh! Oh. Oh no, the banana almost got stuck. Oh, the banana got stuck! The banana got stuck up there!
Oh, no!
No. The banana is stuck up on the window.
Oh my god. That's called a stuck up banana.
Oh, it's not the story of my life. You made contact. You made contact. Oh, jeez.
Oh,
dude. No! He just leaped on you. He just leaped on you. I don't know where he is.
He's right here.
Oh.
Oh! He's on your bed. He's on your bed, ladies and gentlemen.
Take a message, please.
He's busy right now.
Is your head spinning? Is your heart racing? Is there fire in your veins? Are your bones burning? Is your skin yearning? 'Cause you're driving.
Islands. We're on a safari adventure, a hike. We're on a jungle hike, and we've officially lost our tour group. They ditched us. Father was taking too many selfies, so then we got ditched. So now we're on our own in the jungle. I don't know if we're gonna make it. You think we're gonna make it?
You might.
Nice and slow. Need a hand? You got it. They already sent the first aid squad out to find us once. They were calling our names and we didn't answer.
You called our names?
Yeah. And they sent the first aid kit. But they came back, checked on us, and then went back. I think we're close. I'm not sure though. Having fun yet?
Dr. Romoli could see me now.
What would he say to you?
You stupid bloody fool. I told you, no exercise.
Just meters away from kissing the rock. After a long day's climb, this is called... What's this called? The peak? The pike? The needle. This is called the needle. Okay, don't go farther than that.
Have to get up a little bit.
They say not to go farther than that. There you go. You did it.
Apparently you're supposed to kiss the rock, and then you'll have babies. I kind of want babies, so... Not right now, though. Oh, we didn't think we were gonna make it, but we did. The first thing Father is doing, taking a selfie. I guess technically that's the first thing I'm doing because I'm vlogging, which is just a glamorized selfie, so. Now, well. Somehow, we managed to finish that voyage with Father. I thought he was gonna have a heart attack. I was 99% sure he was gonna have a heart attack. He was gasping for breath. He was seeing stars. He was hunched over. They sent out a rescue mission searching for us. But we're back in the hotel room. And actually, as soon as we got back in the hotel room, he wanted to go out adventuring again. I need to relax for a little bit. Okay, I put on sunscreen like 3 times a day. I've applied it heavily. I've worn shirts, I've worn hats, and still, my sunburn is on fleek right now. Look at how pink and blotchy I am. I am disgusting. I'm such a white.
On the marae, so before everything happens on the marae, we're gonna give our offering to the gods. So we have the 3 rangatiras over here. They have a basket of fruits, which actually we're gonna give it as an offering. Now what's gonna happen is before everything happens, the warriors over here will do a chant. And the warrior will ask them a question in Kukaran Māori, and you know what to say? All they have to say is, I meitaki. To each one of you, and you hand your basket to the warrior standing on the marae.
Hi, my camera's in underwater mode right now. Plus, I have a large thing in my mouth, so you can't understand what I'm trying to say. So I'm going to translate for you, 2 weeks later. You look really beautiful today. Wow, you are a good-looking person. Now let's show them where these dreams come true. Yeah. Under the sea, yeah, under the sea. It's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Under the sea. Oh, under the sea. Yeah. Darling, it's better. You know I get you wetter under the sea. Just this time, it seems that everything has changed. We don't mind. And nothing will ever be the same. Yeah, like I ain't did it in a minute. With a down under flow, you could go and hop in it. So come with me, I gotta show you. Yeah. Baby, let me take you where you wanna go to. And that's under the sea. Yeah, under the sea. Yeah, darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Under the sea.
All right, American, warm up. Okay, now look like you say, okay. All right, now warrior, when you're ready, you can be the New Zealand record for this one over here. Okay, when you're ready, one hand in the bottle. One in around, okay, always holding tight, eh? Hold tight the coconuts. When you're ready, one to go, hop! Yeah, keep your feet wide of the coconuts, eh? Keep them tight. Yes, that one. Keep your body close to the coconut. Yeah, straight up, up, up. Oh,
it's really good.
Oh.
Yeah, there.
Bring us the coconut.
Oh, what are you doing? Alright, now stop over there, warrior, stop over there, post to the camera.
Okay, buddy, now you gotta really go. Right.
Let's see him look.
I don't think there's actually someone in there.
Oh.
Okay, he's touching.
Hey, you eat him, you can touch him.
Here's today's recap. We snorkeled, as you could probably tell. I don't even know why I need to give you this recap. Then we went to a thing, I climbed a coconut tree, I won, I did the USA dance. Hey, last night, funny story, I got called up on stage
and I was supposed to kiss the girl on the right cheek, and I ended up going for the left cheek, but she was turning for the right cheek, so we had like a moment where it was almost lip locking, and I think she was like 16, so I probably would have gone to jail, and I would have been sacrificed for their culture, but almost a very awkward moment on stage. But I lost the dance battle then, and my dad was not proud of me. He disowned me after that. I tried to whip in the Cook Islands. They're not going to hear about the whip until like 2024, so rookie mistake.
We just got done watching a rugby game. I'm not exactly sure what was going on. The black team tackled the brown team, and the brown team tackled the black team, and the black team won, I guess, because they had more points than the brown team. But it was fun watching them tackle each other, and they got in a fight or two, and I almost got hit by the ball, and I sat under a coconut tree and almost died. Apparently not supposed to do that. Breakfast of champions.
Welcome to Cook Islands.
Mine's plain. Once again, the one dog on the beach, out of all the people, finds my dad. He just perches next to him. He doesn't even have food this time. But he found him. He's got a reputation. I have food. Dog doesn't come to me. Have to buy a giant 2-liter tub of ice cream and eat it all by yourself in the Cook Islands. That's what I'm going to attempt to do. Here's before. 10 minutes later, this is where we're at. I think I'm tapping out right now. Father helped me, but we were not able to finish the whole 2 liters of ice cream. I don't know where we're going to put it. It's probably going to melt. It might go to waste, but it was a valiant effort. My tummy's happy now. Hey guys, just a warning, there's a strong ebb current, so be careful when you're swimming. And if you start drowning, just pull out your cell phone and dial 999, and someone will come save you. Okay, thanks guys.
When Bay leaves you alone, stranded on a deserted island, just girly things.
Now, after reviewing the footage from last night, I don't know what accent, that's like English / New Zealandish, we'll just do regular accent. After reviewing the footage from last night, I wanted to take a moment to compare booties. Now, first up, we have the tourist booty. Now let's compare it to the local booty. Example number two, tourist booty. Okay, that was more of a whole body in general, but you get the point. Versus local booty or body. Who won? Who had the better booty? Who had the better body? Leave a comment below and a detailed description of whose booty you appreciated the most. Personally, I thought they each were unique. The tourist booty had a nice innocent vibe to it, kind of didn't know what they're doing. You could teach them a few things. The local booty, I don't know if I could handle the local booty, but they both had a lot to offer, I thought. This has been Inappropriate Tourism with Cookie. Let's move on.